Good morning, all of you. I'm your science teacher, and today I'm going to teach you science again. Today we start our sixth chapter of science, that is changes around us. So in your surrounding, you see the different types of changes. And suppose another thing we discuss first, suppose you are a magician. So which type of things you want to change? Something, suppose you thought that you change in your nose, and you want to sleep in the air, and you want to take a magical pencil, you want to become a king, you want to make a palace. But this is not possible, because we don't have any magical power. But except these magical power, many changes we see in our surroundings. Which type of changes you see? We discussed some types of changes. Some examples we take: falling of leaves from the trees. You see these changes, leaves attached to the branches of the tree, and after some time and in the condition of air or the wind, leaves fall from the tree. And you also see the color changes in the color of the leaves. Leaves of the plant change their color and dry out and fall from the tree. And also you see the changes in the flower. Flower bloom and then wither away. It's bloom in the morning, and after some time or some days it wither away from the plant. This type of changes you see in your surroundings. And also you see the changes in your growth, in your body. Your nails grow, your hairs grow that you are cut regularly. You grow taller and your weight also increase. These are also type of changes. Okay, so different types of changes you see. And by some activity we can try to understand and we also try to differentiate the changes, different types of changes we see, and how we can differentiate these type of changes. Okay, some changes we can try to group the changes. Can all changes around always be reversed? The changes we see in our surrounding, these all type of changes are reversed. So by some activity we can try to understand that all changes are reversed or not. So by first activity, we take a balloon and blow it, and remember that does not burst. We blow the balloon and care that the balloon does not burst. We see that the shape and the size of the balloon have changed. And then let the air escape from the balloon. What we see? We see that the balloon convert back into their original shape and size. Okay. Then take a piece of paper and fold it as a aeroplane. We prepare the aeroplane from the paper and fold and prepare a folding paper and prepare a aeroplane and flying it. You also enjoy it. And can be able to convert back a plain paper from the aeroplane folded paper? Yes, we are able to take their in original shape. And the next activity we take a dough, some dough, and prepare a ball and roll out a roti or chapati. And if I told you that, can you able to bake into dough from the chapati? Or again, if you don't like the shape of the chapati, you again back convert into ball of the dough. Yes, we are able to convert back into a dough or the ball of the dough. So if I, after these three activity, I ask you a question, is that in activity first and in activity second and in the activity third, these activities are reversed or not? Here we see the changes. These changes are reversed or not? What is your answer? Obviously your answer is yes. We are able to reverse chapati into roti into ball and aeroplane back into paper and balloon, blow balloon back into their original shape. And then we do this, do next activity in activity four. In the first activity, we take the balloon, and after blowing the balloon, if we pinch with a pencil or by a pin, what will happen? Balloon is washed. And okay, and we can do the next activity. In this activity, we take the paper. Why we prepare an aeroplane from that paper? We take this paper again and draw aeroplane on it by the pencil and cut the drawing outline by the scissor and take aeroplane shape. And can be able to back into their original paper shape or the original paper in this condition? No. And in the condition of balloon after pinch with the pin? No, because balloon is burst. And in this activity, paper is cut. So we are not convert back into a plain paper and their original paper. And the third activity, we prepared a chapati from a dough ball and bake on the tawa. So, and this condition can be able to convert back into dough, the baked chapati, convert back into the dough. What is your answer in these three activity? Bursting of balloon, cutting of an aeroplane shape, and baked chapati can be able to convert back into their original shape or their original condition. These activity is reversed or not? Obviously not. In first three activity we see that these changes are reversed, and next three activity we see that these are not reversed. Okay, so why on the basis of this one category, on the basis of reversibility, we classify the changes. Some changes are reversible and some changes are irreversible. Okay. Then here we give some in the table 6.1, we see some examples of the changes. We classify the changes into reversed or non-reversed. So if the changes is reversed, so we write yes. And if the change is irreversible, so we write no. Okay, so in the first example, raw egg to boiled egg. If we boiled a raw egg, this change is reversed or not? Can be able to get back raw egg from the boiled egg? So what is your answer? Yes. No, we are not able to get back raw egg from the boiled egg. And in the cases of batter to idli, we know that how idli is prepared. Batter is baked on hot steam and it takes a fixed shape, and we are not able to bake batter from the idli. So our answer is no. And in the case of wet cloth to dry cloth, what is your answer? We are again get back the wet cloth from the dry cloth. Yes, we dip into the water and we are again we get back wet cloth. So our answer is yes. Okay. And in the next one, woolen yarn to knitted sweater. Woolen yarn means the thread of wools, and knitted a sweater. Can we get back the wool from the sweater? Yes, by the unknitted of the sweater we get back the woolen yarn. So it is an example of reversible changes. So our answer is yes. Okay. And the next one, grain to its flour. When we grind the grain and get the flour from the grains, can we get back the grains from the flour? Obviously our answer is no, because it is a irreversible change. It is not a reversible change. Then the next example, cold milk to hot milk. We boil the milk, we boil the cold milk, and this milk will be hot after some time. And can we get back the cold milk from the hot milk? What is our answer? Obviously yes, by cooling the milk we get back the cold milk from the hot milk. So it is an example of reversible change. Okay. Straight string to a coiled string. We take a straight string and convert into a coiled string. Can we able to get back our straight string from the coiled string? Yes, because it is made up of metal or made up of a plastic, so we are able to get back into the straight string. So it is a type of reversible change. Our answer is yes. Yes, we are get back straight string from the coiled string. And the next one is bud to flower. In the morning we see that flower bloom, bud bloom into the flower. And can we get back the bud from the flower? And you see anywhere flower convert into bud, back into the bud? No, because it is a irreversible change. It is not a reversed. Milk to paneer, it is also non-reversible change, irreversible change. We cannot back milk from the paneer. Cow dung to the biogas, obviously not. Guess we cannot get back cow dung from the biogas. So it is also a irreversible change. And stretched rubber. So we see that the length is increased. Suppose this is our rubber band, and we stretch from the both ends and change their length. And after holding from remove force from the band, we see that rubber band is coming back into their original size or their original shape. So it is a reversible change. Okay. And then last one is ice cream to molten ice cream. the ice cream. After some time it become melt. So a melt ice cream we can freeze into the freezer, and we also get back the ice cream from the molten ice cream. Okay, so these are the example. This is also the example of reversible change. It can be reversed back. Okay, so on the basis of these, on the basis of their reversible property, we classify the changes which we see in our surrounding. Okay, so next point we discussed from tomorrow, we study from tomorrow, our 6.2. So what we discuss today, we see that in our first chapter, changes around us, we see that different types of changes are there in our surrounding. Falling of leaves from the tree, change the shape in the rubber, in the milk to paneer, different types of changes we see, and growth in our body, our changes in our body and growth of our body is a reversible change or not? It is not a reversible change. If we grow a time, we cannot get back into our childhood. Okay, so, and we see some activities, blow of balloon is a reversible change, and after bursting the balloon, it is not, it is an example of irreversible change. And if we fold a paper and prepare an aeroplane, it is an example of reversible change. If we draw the aeroplane and cut by the scissor, it is not a reversible change. And we make a chapati from the dough, we get back the dough from the roll out chapati or the roti, and it is an example of reversible change. But if we bake the chapati on the tawa, we are not get back dough ball from the chapati. So it is a irreversible change. And we see a table 6.1. In this table, we discuss different types of changes we see in our surrounding, and we classify or we write yes or no on the basis of their reversible property. If the change is reversible, so we write yes, or if the change is not reversible, so we write no. Okay, I hope you can understand. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Good luck.